Hey, this is Victor Antonio here in my home office. One of the questions I get a lot is, you know, Victor, I want to be a motivational speaker. You know, can you help me? Can you guide me? And so I thought I'd record this video, you know, have some time, sit here, record this video, and I thought I would just point people to this video so I don't have to keep answering the question over and over again. You know, one of the things I discovered about the speaking business, and I think it's a, you know, I don't know where to start, so I'll just try to find a spot to start, because it's not an easy question to really answer. Because there's a lot of things I discovered about the business that nobody told me about. You know what I mean? Things that nobody really talks to you about. Nobody says these things. You won't find them in a book type of thing. And nobody wants to, you know, kind of, you know, look at the bad side or the downside of being a speaker. The first thing is that, you know, when I hear somebody say to me, you know, Victor, I want to be a motivational speaker, you know, I usually respond like, yeah. And the reason I give that answer, and I try not to be discouraging, because I really want to encourage people, if you want to speak, you know, and you have a message, which everybody has, I encourage you to go forth, you know, and prosper type of thing, you know, Spock. But you have to kind of look at this thing as a business. And think of a product that's readily available in the market, for example, something that you can find almost anywhere. And let's say it's a bottle of water, right? And today, if I ask you to pay, you know, $20 for a bottle of water, you probably go, what? I'm not paying $20 for a bottle of water, Victor, you nuts. And then I would ask you, well, why wouldn't you pay $20 for a bottle of water? I says, well, I can water anywhere. In other words, I can buy, you know, a dollar bottle, a $2 bottle, you know, over here, or maybe get $3 from the vending machine over there, but I wouldn't pay $20. And so that's because water has become a commodity, right? You can even get it free out of the faucet if you really want it. There's a marketing job that was done on us, right? How to get by bottled water instead of just getting it from the actual faucet. That's another story. And so I tell people, I said, the reason that the bottled water is so low is because it's a commodity. You can get it anywhere, and you know you don't want to pay much because you can get it anywhere. It's a commodity. And so when somebody says they want to be a motivational speaker, you know, it's the first thing that pops into my head. Water, right? Because water is a commodity, and I hate to say it, but so are motivational and inspirational speakers. Because, you know, there's in economics, or if you go to business school, they'll teach you about a barrier to entry. Barrier to entry in a market is that if there's a low barrier to entry into a market, that means anybody can get into a market. If there's a high barrier to entry, very few people can get into that market. Remember that concept. We'll come back to that in just a bit. And right now, if you want to be a motivational speaker, it doesn't really take much to be in the market as a motivational speaker. Now, let's put whether you're good or, you know, super to the side. The fact is that most people who want to be motivational speakers can jump in the market anytime, which means there's a low barrier to entry. Anybody can get in. And if anybody can get in and anybody can be a motivational speaker or a self-proclaimed motivational speaker, that means you're a commodity. What does that mean to you personally? And this is what I want to really talk to you about, is that because motivational speakers are a commodity, you know, you'll find the top 5% who will get the big bucks, but the majority are not making a lot of money as motivational speakers. I'm sorry, but there is a harsh reality that no one even told me about. I had to figure it out on my own. And so there'll be people like, you know, in the top 5% who will make a lot of money as motivational speakers. They're well known, they're well published, they got a lot of marketing money behind them, they've been around a long time, 20 plus years. So these are people who are established already. So those are the, what I call, the market anomalies. Put those to the side. The other 95% is struggling to make a living. And again, if you look at the majority of motivational speakers, and I really mean the majority of motivational speakers, they're not making a lot of money. I mean, these are people who are working during the day at another job, and then when they got time, they'll go speak. And what the irony is that they're going to talk to you about, you know, freedom, pursue your passion, all that wonderful stuff. And then at the end of the day, they drive off back to their 9-to-5 job the very next day. Reality. Sorry. There it is. And so if you want to be a motivational speaker, realize that this is almost like a music business. In other words, you can get music anywhere, so you can get a speech anywhere. So therefore, nobody wants to pay a lot of money for a speech. Again, unless you're in that type of 5%. Think of this as a music business, and you get the parallels right down the middle. You understand it. And that is that it's not easy to be in this business because people don't want to pay you a lot of money unless you're well-known, the top 5%. If you want to stretch it to 10, fine. Top 10%, doesn't matter. The reality is that 90% plus are not making a lot of money or making a living full-time being a motivational speaker. So when people say, Victor, I want to be a motivational speaker, where do I start? I mean, let's go through some of the basics. You know, join Toastmasters so you can learn how to speak, right? Great organization. My favorite book is Jane Atkinson's The Wealthy Speaker. To me, that's like, I love that book because it's like a blueprint for really thinking about how to approach the speaking business. So again, Jane Atkinson, The Wealthy Speaker. It's the only book I recommend. I love it. I'm sure there are other books out there, but that's the one that resonated with me because I read it after I got started. And so when I read it, I was like, where was this book when I got started, right? So shame on you, Jane, for not having that before when I started. You know, I lost a lot of money because of that. And that book will save you money. And so you go on to Toastmasters, you learn to speak, and then let's say you've polished your speech, and now you have to figure out what market you want to focus in on. Ah, here's where you begin to differentiate yourself and become a non-commodity speaker. See, a lot of speakers basically pick a focus, something they want to focus in on. So maybe it's customer service, maybe it's leadership, whatever it may be. You pick a focus, and you become very good at that focus and make sure that you have the background to support you being in that market. In other words, don't be a customer service speaker if you've never been in customer service, okay? People figure this out very quickly. But if you just want to talk about inspirational stories, motivational stories, I'm just letting you know right now, it's tough. It really is tough, and we're in the middle of a recession still, which means that now when corporations or businesses or associations are hiring people, what they're looking for is that they need to justify the dollars they're spending on you as a speaker. And if you're just a motivational speaker with no real big background or rather big business behind you or experience behind you or you've been in the business for a long time, you know, they're not going to pay you the money because they have to justify to their bosses why they're hiring you. And your resume better look a little thick because if it's a little thin, they're not going to hire you or pay you a lot of money. And a lot of them will say, hey, can you just speak for free? Again, worth doing. I speak for free, you know, 3 to 5 times maybe during the year. If it's a good crowd, big crowd, important people in the crowd, I'll speak to them for free because I know there's a follow-up business from that I'll get. So again, you know, I'm trying to wrap this up in the sense of saying if you want to be a motivational speaker, yes, go ahead and do it. Have realistic expectations in terms of, you know, how much money you're going to make. And again, it's not an easy business. Not everybody can, anybody can get in, but not everybody can make money at it. And that's what a lot of people won't tell you. And so I'm telling you. So am I discouraging you? No, I want you to be a motivational speaker. If that's what you believe your passion is, then do not listen to me and go forward and prosper. But you got to have a plan. You got to have a plan. You just can't sit there and say, you know, Victor, I really believe in my message. I really believe that people will just gravitate towards my message. Ugh. That's your plan, you're screwed, okay? So you got to think of this as a business because that's what it is. A long time ago, back in 2003, somebody told me, Victor, you're not in the speaking business, you're in the marketing business first, which means that if you don't know how to market yourself, package yourself, and put yourself out there in the market, then you know the chances of you making it as a paid motivational speaker on a full-time basis, the odds are against you. And again, I'm not trying to discourage you. I believe that if I give you a realistic outlook of what to expect, then you can anticipate what will happen. And when it comes your way, you say, ah, Victor said this would happen, and then push through that. But if you just go in there naively like a little lamp, thinking, ah, everything's going to be great. You know, pixie dust, stars, everything's wonderful. You're going to be disappointed. And I don't want you to be disappointed. I want you to have a realistic plan and I guess a trajectory to get to that business and make it happen as a motivational speaker. So again, if you really want to be a motivational speaker, there is a price to pay, and it's a very high price. You're going to have to invest time, money, get rejected a lot, and it's going to get frustrating in the first few years or be frustrating in the first few years because nobody wants to pay you because you're just starting out. You'll make a little bit of money. Don't worry about it. You'll make $500 here, $1,500 there. You'll make a little bit of money. But know that it's a long-term game. Okay, this is not a short-term game where you're just going to make it in 2 or 3 years. You know how these people out there says, you know, how to make $1 million in the speaking business, how to make $500,000 in the speaking business a year. Well, you know how those people are making their money? They're making the money by selling you information on how to be a speaker. Not that they're actually making that money themselves. They're making money off of you. You know, they always said that the people who got rich during the gold rush were not the people who actually dug for the actual gold, but the people who sold the pickaxes and the shovels. And sometimes when I see these programs about how you can make $1 million as a speaker in just 1 year, I'm reminded of that. So again, I want you to be successful. I want you to plan it out. But again, if you're the person who you don't have a lot of money in the bank, Then you need to hold on to your job. You need to build your business slowly over time till you get to a point where one day you can quit your job and then be a speaker full time. Okay, so it's not something that you can just quit. I had a gentleman call me up about 2 weeks ago. He says, you know, Victor, I'm tired of my job. You know, I said, you know, we talked a little bit, and he says, I have a family and I just want to quit my job and become a motivational speaker. And I'm thinking, I wouldn't do that. Because it's not like a switch that you can just flip on and all of a sudden you become a motivational speaker. It doesn't happen that way. This takes a while to build, folks. And unless you get that through your head, that it takes a while to build, you got to really put the effort in. Invest time, invest money. You're looking at a 3 to 5 year ramp-up period. I mean, realistically, that's real. 3 to 5 years is real, where you can get to the point where you can say, I quit my day job. So again, 3 years minimum. Okay, some of you may get lucky and do it faster, but I'm just saying, be realistic, 3 to 5 years. So start building now, build slowly, build your message, polish your message, build your brand, market your brand, and then one day, maybe we'll share the stage together. Talk to you later.